Okay, we're back. Yep. We had to zoom out really far to get make this to be able to capture the shape you made here. So what is this shape you made? What did you do?
Well, I took one of these.
Uh-huh.
And then what I did was I built three more off of them.
Oh wow, that's really awesome.
So then it makes a big.
So how many smaller equilateral triangles do you have now?
I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, just like I thought.
Interesting. And that's actually pretty similar to the first way you got 16. Do you see the similarity?
Well, instead of chopping them up into smaller ones, you make them bigger.
Pretty cool. And what I thought another way to go would be just to make this top bit here, that also is a different way to chop up an equilateral triangle into smaller equilateral triangles. This one has 9. So there's a way to do it where you don't chop it up at all and you get 1. Then the next one you got 4, and on this one you got 9, and on yours you got 16.
Yep.
That's interesting. Do you notice anything about those numbers?
Well, 1, 4, 16, you're multiplying by 4 every time, and then 1, 4, 9 are the squares.
Ooh. Interesting.
But 1, 4, 16, they're also, those are squares too.
That's a neat pattern.
Yeah.
If your pattern kept going 1, 4, 16, what do you think the next one would be?
64.
And if my pattern kept going 1, 4, 9, 16, what do you think the next one would be?
Your next one would be 25.
Ah. So there seems to be lots of different ways to chop up equilateral triangles. And that's kind of what he was saying. Maybe we can move the camera down real quick and go back to his blog post.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, this is going to be a little wiggly. Okay. And we'll bring the camera over to the computer. And let's see what he says next. Now, you noticed something kind of fun about him, didn't you?
He has, let's see, I think he has 1,592 followers.
Well, not quite a million. Do you know what that number is?
Is that 100,000?
Yeah, 100,000.
1,592 followers.
Yeah. And what's that number?
19,078,392 views.
Holy moly. He does some really incredible math, actually.
Yeah. So
it makes sense to me that a lot of people follow him. So anyway, so he keeps going. He says, it's easy to cut an equilateral triangle into 4 smaller equilateral triangles, or cut a square into 4 smaller squares. How would you do that?
Well, you'd make a 2x2 square, then put like a plus sign in the middle of them.
Yeah. Or cut a regular hexagon into 6 equilateral triangles. Think of a Trivial Pursuit playing piece. Do you know what Trivial Pursuit is?
It's a trivia game.
Yeah, okay. Less obviously, it is possible to cut a regular octagon into polygon-shaped pieces that are both centrally symmetric and convex. So now he's starting to use some pretty advanced math terms, but that just means they have some sort of symmetry and they don't cross each other. Okay? And he mentions, before we go to the end, which is what I really want to talk about, he mentions a neat theorem that this guy Paul Monsky proved. Now, Paul Monsky was a professor where I went to graduate school, so I actually did a little bit of work with him. So it was kind of cool to see his name. But Paul Monsky proved that it's impossible to cut a square into an odd number of triangles all the same area. Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
So you can cut a square into 2 triangles. Do you see how to do that?
You cut it in half.
Okay. And you could cut it into 4 triangles. Do you see how to cut a square into 4 triangles that are all the same size?
Well, you make them isosceles triangles, and then you cut across, you take the you cut it in half, and then you take the opposite cut.
Ah, okay. But you can't cut a square into
like
3 triangles that all have the same area.
Hmm.
Isn't that surprising?
Yeah.
So that was a cool theorem. But what I really want to talk about is at the end. He has some amazing pictures right there that are going to allow us to talk a little bit about angles. Okay?
Yep.
So let's do that. Let's look at this picture, and I want to get your thoughts on some of these things, and I'll try to zoom in as much as I can. And then we'll pick one in particular and try to figure out some of the angles, okay?
Okay.